Okay, so let's see how we'd solve this problem. The first thing we're going to do is change the square routine into a cube routine and change the math accordingly. So now we're going to change square to cube, and instead of computing f times f, now we simply compute f times f times f. Now, since our new name is cube here, we're going to have to scroll all the way back down here, and instead of launching square, we've now launched cube. The next thing we have to change is the allocation. Now instead of running this on 64 elements, we want to run this on 96 elements. And we've conveniently written this code such that everything is done in terms of array size, including the allocations. So that should be all that we need to do. Now let's go over to my shell window and demonstrate that this works. Okay, now we're going to do it in our own terminal window. First, I'll make sure to show you that I've actually made the changes in this file. So notice that we now have a cube routine, f times f times f, and now 96. Now we're going to compile it into a cube executable, and then we're going to run it. And notice that instead of printing out squares now, it prints 0, 1, 8, 27, and so on. So 96 cubes altogether. Okay, good work. Let's move on.